Hello everyone and welcome to the second class of geography. I'm Himani here, and if you remember in last week's class I gave you some questions to answer and most of you have answered correctly, but at some places I found that you people have some doubts. So children, I'm here to explain those points so that your doubts are cleared. Children, just look at this picture. You might have come across this picture many a times, especially when we are looking at the Google Maps and looking for some place. Not only this, when we are ordering for some online commodity, we come to know that these people are able to locate us very quickly. Even when we are hiring any cab, they are able to locate our position. How is it possible? It is all possible with the help of GPS. GPS is Global Positioning System. With the help of the satellite it is done. So we have latitudes which are the horizontal lines and longitudes which are the vertical lines. These are imaginary lines placed on the earth, and they form a grid. The place where the latitude and longitude meet is this the intersecting point, and that intersecting point becomes the position, and it is taken by the satellite. So wherever we are, some or the other latitude and longitude is intersecting at that point, and it gives the position through satellite. So this is how location is decided. So location of a place of a person can be decided by the help of latitude and longitudes together. Now look at this picture. It is the model of the earth. As you all know, earth is spherical or geoid in the shape. Here in this picture you can see equator is marked with the dotted lines. Equator is the horizontal line, where you can say it runs from east to west or west to east. It is marked as 0 degree. At the top you can see North Pole. It is marked as 90 degree north, and at the bottom is South Pole, which is marked as 90 degree south. So equator divides our earth into two hemispheres. Hemisphere means two halves. So this equator divides our earth into two halves, northern hemisphere, which is at the top, and the southern hemisphere, which is at the bottom. Hemisphere means half. So now in this picture you can see that there are some more horizontal lines. Yes, these are the latitudes. Latitudes are the parallel lines which run on the parallel imaginary lines which run on the surface of the earth. These lines are parallel, they never meet, and they are placed as one latitude per degree. So here they have marked at the difference of 20-20, because it is not possible to show latitude of each and every degree. It will be too complicated and very difficult to understand. So they have marked at the difference of 20, but actually the latitudes are placed one at each degree. So now how many latitudes are there in all? So very clear, if equator is 0 and North Pole and South Pole are 90. So let us start counting. Just after equator, moving toward from in the northern hemisphere from equator to North Pole, let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, it makes 90. Same way in the southern hemisphere, if we start counting from 1 to 90, it makes 90. So 90 plus 90 equals to 180. Now what about equator? We have not counted equator anywhere. And equator is the most important latitude. So let us count equator also. And thus the total number of latitude is 181. Now look at this picture. In this picture you can see some important latitudes. As I said, equator is the most important latitude because it is the centermost, plus it is dividing our earth into two hemispheres. just towards the north of this equator you can see Tropic of Cancer at 23.5 degrees north, and below equator in southern hemisphere you can see Tropic of Capricorn, which is at 23.5 degrees south. In the northern hemisphere again, if you come just little above Tropic of Cancer, you can see Arctic Circle at 66.5 degrees north. In the same way, in southern hemisphere you will find Antarctic Circle in at 66.5 degrees south. So this way we have five important latitudes. They are equator, Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn at 23.5 degrees north and south respectively. Same way, Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle at 66.5 degrees north and south respectively. These are the five major latitudes. Apart from this, you can also see that there are some zones mentioned. What are those? They are heat zones. Now, what are heat zones? Heat zones, actually our earth is divided into some zones, some sections on the basis of the heat that we receive from the sun, because sun is the only source of heat, light and energy to us. So you can see from Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn, that is 23.5 degrees north to 23.5 degrees south, it is marked as torrid zone. Torrid means very hot. So this zone is the hottest zone, as it receives direct sun rays throughout the year. Moving towards its north and south, we can see temperate zone, north temperate zone in northern hemisphere and south temperate zone in the southern hemisphere. It runs from 23.5 degrees north to 66.5 degrees north in northern hemisphere and 23.5 degrees south to 66.5 degrees south in southern hemisphere. This is the zone which receives slant rays of the sun, means it is neither too hot nor too cold. It receives moderate sun rays and has a moderate type of climate. Moderate means medium. Just moving towards the poles, we can see a zone marked as frigid in the northern hemisphere and in southern hemisphere also. This frigid zone, as the name suggests, is the coldest zone, as it receives very slant rays or no rays of the sun throughout the year. So this is the coldest zone. It runs from 66.5 degrees north to North Pole in northern hemisphere and 66.5 degrees south to South Pole in southern hemisphere. So this way we have three heat zones: torrid zone, hottest one; temperate zone, moderate zone; and frigid zone, the coldest zone. So children, remember these heat zones, major latitudes, as we will come across them again and again in different chapters for different reasons. Now look at this picture. This is again a model of Earth depicting some lines which are running from top to bottom. Yes, at the top you can see that it is marked as North Pole and bottom it's South Pole. So these lines are running vertically, that is from top to bottom. So these long lines are longitudes. Okay, they run from North Pole to South Pole and they meet at North Pole and South Pole. The distance between these lines, these longitudes, is maximum at the equator due to the bulge of the earth, and it is minimum or no gap at the poles. Now in this picture you can see that there is a middle line which is marked as 0 degree. Yes, this is the centermost longitude, which is known as prime meridian. Just as equator is dividing our earth into two halves, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, that is the horizontal division, and this is the vertical division done by prime meridian. So it divides our earth into two hemispheres, eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. You can see it is very well marked also. So toward the reader's right hand side is the eastern hemisphere and towards the reader's left hand side is the western hemisphere. This line is known as prime meridian, as it passes through Greenwich, which is in London. It is also known as Greenwich Mean Time because all the clocks of the world are set according to the time of this meridian. Means the whole world follows the time as per the time which is observed in Greenwich at 0 degree, which is the prime meridian. Not only this, this Greenwich, if we will study the time, we will find that there is a gap of 4 minutes at each degree. Means when we move from prime meridian towards the east, we plus the time, and when we are moving towards the west, we subtract. How? Suppose it is 5 p.m. at Greenwich and you are standing 10 degrees away from prime meridian in the eastern side. So it will add. So 10 degrees eastern side, 1 degree 4 minutes difference. So 10 degrees, 4 into 10 makes 40. 40 minutes difference. So if, and it has to be plus. So if it is 5 p.m. at prime meridian, then the place, the point at which you are standing, which is 10 degrees away from prime meridian, means you are having 40 minutes difference. So your time at that place will be 5:40 p.m. Got it? So this way, towards the eastern hemisphere we add and towards the western hemisphere we subtract. So this is also very important thing which we need to remember. Just look at this map, children. This is also the showing the same thing which I have just spoken. There are some in the middle, you can see that Greenwich is marked with dotted lines. There are some lines, some places which are marked as plus 3, plus 2, plus 5 in the eastern zone, and some places which are marked as minus 10, minus 2, minus 5 at in the western zone. These places are showing the number of hours they are ahead or backward, behind. So the eastern zone is always ahead, so they have shown with the symbol of plus. Plus 3 means this place has showing the time 3 hours ahead of GMT. If it is in the western side and mentioned as minus 7, means that region is behind GMT by 7 hours. Now just look at this picture, children. It is a picture of, again, a model of Earth with latitudes and longitudes together. This is the grid which is formed by latitudes and longitudes. Equator marking in the center and prime meridian vertically. Other latitudes and longitudes are also mentioned. So this grid is helpful in locating. Now just look at this map. It's a globe. And children, if you look carefully, equator is marked with blue broken line, whereas prime meridian just in the in towards your left side in this, you'll find prime meridian marked with broken red line. So children, if we see that, we'll find that India, which is marked in yellow color, it lies in northern hemisphere, as it we are in the northern hemisphere, north to the equator, and as per prime meridian we are towards the east. as per equator we are towards north, and as per prime meridian we are towards east. Means our India is located in northern hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. We can't say northeastern because there is no hemisphere as northeastern hemisphere itself means half sphere. So if you say northeastern, then it is not half sphere, it is 1/4. So it is totally wrong. Don't ever say that it is northeastern. Just remember, when you are mentioning the location, you have to mention that India is located in northern hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. So now children, look at this picture. It is there in your textbook also. In this you can very well see our India's location. You can see we have Arabian Sea towards its western side, Bay of Bengal in eastern side, Indian Ocean southern side, and you can see Tropic of Cancer passing almost from the center of the country. You can also see that there are some lines crisscrossing in the middle. It is showing the extent. Extent means from which latitude to which latitude and from which longitude to which longitude our country runs. That is extension. So our country's boundaries, just look carefully. Our southernmost tip, I'm repeating, our southernmost tip is at 8 degrees 4 minutes north, whereas our northern boundary is 37 degrees 6 minutes north. Same way, our eastern boundary is 97 degrees 25 minutes east, and our western boundary is 68 degrees 7 minutes east. Now, why I am asking, I'm saying east and north and north south east west? Very simple. Just now we have done it. India lies in northern and eastern hemisphere. So our north and south extensions will always say only north because it is in northern hemisphere, and our east and west extensions will write only east because it is in the eastern hemisphere. If you see the expansion of our country, from north to south, just look at the map carefully, it is 2,933 kilometers, and from east to west it is 2,933 kilometers, and from north to south it is 3,214 kilometers, almost very close to each other. In terms of degrees, if we say, it is approximately 30 degrees, but when we look at the map we find that it is taller, but actually it is not tall, it is not long one. From north south extension seems to be larger than east west, but it is not, it is almost equal. So just now we studied about time and longitudes. So children, let me tell you one thing. When we talk about time is calculated in two terms, local time and standard time. Just listen carefully. The time at a particular longitude is its local time. I repeat, the time shown or reflected at a particular longitude is the local time. But the time which is standard for the whole country is the standard time. Now, you might be confused, definitely, I'm sure. So, let me make it clear how it works. So, children, you can see our eastern borders, our eastern boundary is 97.25 degree east. And our western is 68.7. If we see, it is almost 30 degrees difference. And as I said, there is a difference of 4 minutes per degree. So if it is a gap of 30 degrees, so 30 into 4, how much will it be? 120 minutes. 120 minutes equals to 2 hours. So, there will be a difference in time in both the points. When it will be 2 p.m. in Gujarat, it will be 4 p.m. in Arunachal Pradesh. Great confusion. Now, how our trains will run, how our TV shows will run at the same time? There will be a chaos. Now, to solve these problems, to solve these chaos and chaotic situations, we have taken the centermost longitude of our country. Country's centermost longitude, which is at 82.5 degrees north, is taken as the standard meridian. This standard meridian passes through Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh. It is known as standard meridian of India. Now, the time which is at this, the local time of this meridian, or you can say the time which is at this meridian, is followed by the whole country. Whatever the time is reflected at this longitude is followed by the whole country. They don't follow the local times. They follow the time which is reflected at standard meridian. That is a standard time, so that all the confusions are cleared. I hope you have understood this very well. So when the location is asked, we have to tell where our India is located. It is located in northern and eastern hemispheres, and you have to mention the degrees. 8.4 is the southernmost tip, and the northern post most tip is 37.6 degrees north. Same way, eastern is 97.25 degrees east, and western boundary is 68.7 degree east. Extension almost 30 degrees, and it lies in northern hemisphere, surrounded by Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, and Indian Ocean are the water bodies. Apart from this, we have many other neighboring countries also, like Pakistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar. So these are all things which you have already studied in your previous classes. Now let's move to something else. What else? Now let's move to the size of our country. Okay, it seems to be a very large country with lot of variations. So the size of the country. So India is very vast in size. Its area is of 3.28 million square kilometers, and it accounts for 2.4% of the total geographical area of the world. It occupies 2.4% of the entire world's area, and it is its own area is 3.28 million square kilometers. And you all know India is a vast country, so it is the 7th largest country. Its land boundary is 15,200 kilometers, and coastline is 7,500 7516.6 kilometers. It is very vast, and so children, India is very vast in size. It is the 7th largest country in the world, with the total land boundary of about 15,200 kilometers and coastline of 7,516.6 kilometers. Not only this, its area is 3.28 million square kilometers, which is 2.4% of the total geographical area of the world. So it is very vast country, and if you see the map, you can see that its east-west extension seems to be larger than northwest. No problem, it's almost equal. So children, till now we have discussed about latitudes, longitudes, and India's location extension. Now in the next video, we will conclude the chapter and the remaining topics of the chapter, India and the world, India, its neighboring countries. So children, so I'm giving you two questions as homework, which will be reflected in the video in the end, and it will be shown separately also. You have to answer these two questions in your notebook. Take a pic and send them to me. For notebook, if you don't have any new notebook, you can take any old notebook for your homework. The submission has to be by tomorrow 7 p.m. Not late than that, otherwise it will not be considered. And the book PDF of the book is already shared with you, so you can consult the chapter, read the chapter, go through the video as many as times you want. You can discuss with me, but you can't discuss with any other person, nor you can consult any internet, any website. So I want your honest answers by tomorrow 7 p.m. I hope you have understood very well. Thank you so much, children. See you next week.